Hi, I want to show you how to use the emailing helper class in your component. The email helper class is a class that gets added to your component's helper area and therefore available on every page, and with which you can then send emails. We could look at the helper class by going to a component that has it included and then into helpers, and the file name is usually the component name email. I've opened it already here, and as you can see, it's in just a basic abstract class that takes Joomla's emailer, which is this Jmail, and it gets an instance of it and adds it to mail and then loads in the variables that's required. Now we'll come back to this in a moment. If we look at a component, what you need to do first, if you are going to use this feature in any of your components, let us open this learning manager. And then go to libraries and helpers, and you'll see that the add email helper has been set to on. And that only places the helper class in your component. That's all it does. It doesn't implement it anywhere else. So at the moment, that means that if you click yes here, you need to still create fields that you are going to load to your config area. Now, if you don't know about the config yet, it means you've skipped some tutorials. But it's basically this area here, which gives you the ability to add configuration options to your component's option area. So if we click here and I scroll down, you'll see that there is mail configuration and a whole lot of fields there. Now these fields correspond to the Joomla's default fields, if you didn't know. So if you would like to create these fields and you need some info on what they should be and what should be their names and everything, then go look at the Joomla global configuration XML, and you'll see all the settings in that file. For our purposes, I'm simply going to show you how the fields look like. We also have the DKM implementation available, and even those fields, you'll need to look at the code to know what their names should be. So there's a difference, of course, between name and label and description. And when we refer to name, then that is the value that will be used in the code. Okay, I'll show you what I mean. So let's just close out here. I'm going to go back to the code. So, for example, that word mailer actually means that the name of the field is called mailer. And the name of the field is called that and that, and so it goes on. So these are all the fields that needs to be set. If your component, if we go back to the component, let me just close this. You would see there's this options area. So I'm going to open that. Once it's open, you'll see there is a mail configuration and a DKM area, DKIM. So let's open the mail. You see that it has the mailer status. So it's either set to off, then no emails will go out, or to on. If it's set to on, you can decide whether you want to overwrite the global function, the global variables. Now the global variables are set in your Joomla's components global area. So you would go to global configurations, and then you'd go to server, and then there's this mail settings here. Okay, now these are the main or the global settings that will be used in the in any component that does not add these settings in their config. So if you didn't create those fields and added it to your component, but you ticked the button to sort of add the helper class to your component, then that means that it will basically fall back to these settings in your Joomla's default area. So just that you know. And these are the values that you need to override. If you want your component in some way to use other PHP mail or other send mail or other what's the other one? SMTP values, then that of the global, you need to set it here. And that is basically what this area can do. So if you use global, it falls back to the Joomla global. Otherwise, you can override it on this level and send it out in a way that is what you would like. The DKIM area is a more advanced area, which basically allows you to encrypt and secure emails sent out from you to authenticate that it was really you that sent it. This is very helpful to sort of show the people that receive these emails that it's not spam and it really comes from you. It's more advanced. I would encourage you to read up on it. These are the values that usually would be required to be added: a private key, a public key, and obviously these top areas here. If this is set to no, obviously it will not be used. If it's set to yes, please ensure to add the values. Otherwise, it still will not be used. Okay, so that's basically the values that you need to still create. Component Builder does not do this for you. You need to do it. I could possibly foresee that in the future we might add this. If you tick the helper class, it adds these values for you. But even then, if you have done it manually, we'll make sure that it doesn't add them twice. So as long as these values obviously be the same names, we will not actually somehow identify that and then not add them dynamically, so to avoid clashes. But for the meantime, it's not automatically being added, and so you need to do that manually if you want it to be there. If you don't, like I've said before, it will fall back to the Joomla global. So to explain that to you on the code level, basically it gets from the configuration the mailer function, and then it checks whether it's global. If it is global, then it implements Joomla's values. If it's not global, it implements your component's values, and that is basically what it will do. Now you can read through the code, but the most important area really is this area, to know what is all the various options that you have in the signature to send out mail. So it's able to really send out a lot of mail, but nonetheless you also need to consider, you know, your server's own limitations, since we obviously don't want you to spam people. We do not override those values. We are simply using the Joomla default helper, JMailer, and it has been extended from another class, and so there are a lot of features in here. And if you want to know more about them, you can read up on obviously the JMailer class from Joomla, as well as read through this code here and see how we implement it. These are the DKM values that you would need and in your component to be able to use the DKIM encryption. But you could also read up on this and check out this function here up to there in its way that it's implementing these features. It obviously is adding it to the mailer, and most of the work is done in the mailer. So it's basically adding the data to the mailer, and the mailer takes care of the rest. Okay, and so here it sends it off, and if there is an error, so let's say for some reason it didn't, you know, work out well, then it checks whether your component helper class, so your component has a helper class, it's just this file here, if it has a store message variable or method. So if we were to go check this, you see that there is this store message method in the helper class. This is a custom method that I wrote. Now you can write it any way you like, but the signature should be the same. Okay, so here is the same signature, you'll see it. So basically, this area, that and that is dynamically updated to your component. So it uses your component name here and your component name there. But this store message is basically not, you cannot change that. But it takes the send email, the recipient, the subject, the body, the text only, and the mode, and it says that it's email. So you can have different types. So if you look at the method, the type can be anything. We are obviously wanting to do different things on different types. So if we send an SMS and it didn't fail, we want to store the message. If we did this or that. So this kind of feature isn't only used when something didn't work, but also if it worked, if it was sent, it's gonna store it. So it's a way to store the message so that you can maybe let your users go, if they log in, they can see messages sent to them and this kind of stuff. So this is what the store message does. And as you see, it's a whole huge custom method that I wrote, and it does different things for different, and you can update it and change it, pause the video, copy it down, don't really matter. Just as you realize, this is actually something you write up yourself. You just need to make sure that that part is the same. The rest is up to you and how you deal with it. Okay, so that is really implementing the Learning Manager emailer in your component. Maybe I should show you where I implemented it, at least in one area. Okay, let me do that. Okay, so I have this component called Job Tracking System. If I open it up, you'll see that it actually has that function, adding the helper email. It's got it selected. You see there, add helper, set to on. Then the view in which we are using the email method is the job order view. Basically, we want to email the client the job order when it's created. So let me show you how I've implemented it there. So here is the job order, and I would basically then click on this area here, email. Now I can update that to whatever email I like, testing at vdm.io something, just send it into nothing. And then once the email has been sent, it actually lets me know. See there, in the, it says email was sent successfully. So that's basically what the emailer does. It's just this button, it sends this document to my client. And also, if I want to send it to my store, the people that does the job, I could also do that here. I'm not going to explain to you the reality of taking this content, adding it to the email and sending it. That I would expect you need to know, and you need to learn or study to do that yourself. I'm simply explaining to you how to use the email helper class. So we'll go to the code and I'll show you how I do it, and mostly maybe I'll give you some pointers, but I won't go into detail about how that is done. Okay, so let's go to the code. So here we are in the job order. So first thing here is obviously some JavaScript. So there's the send email function. It gets a set of values, and then it basically gives it over to the send email server function, which sends it as a J object. A JSON request to the server. The send email is the task, and when it gets a response, that's when you get the notification. Okay, so that's simply the JavaScript of it. So now if we go to PHP, previous tutorials we explained how to use the AJAX class. I'm gonna just touch on it briefly. You basically have your input here. This is where you set up your controller. Let me show you that. So you'll see in your controller there is this send email class. That's what basically was defined in this field here. Okay, and you'll see that there is basically three variables, and they are should be filtered in this way, and they are passed over to these methods, and you should be logged in user. So if we look at the code again, it basically, this is the task down here, it triggers the task, it checks for those values, and then passes it over to this method, which is in the model, as a model. So we go to models, Ajax. So here is the model. Let's just scroll down to the send email. So here is the send email. This again is a custom script. So if I was to go back here, I close this, you'd see there's the, in this Ajax method, there's a lot, I mean, look at that here, you can see it. I've scrolled down way down. There's a lot of other custom methods here, but this is another custom method I've written called send mail. Gets the mail, the HTML, the type, it does the necessary cleansing and whatever, and then it basically over here we are calling the email helper. We're using the send method, we're passing the variables, and we set the result in here. And if the result is obviously true, we let the user know, otherwise we give him the error. Okay, so that is the short end of it. I'm also using this email body to help me build the email, because I want to make sure that it's got all the necessary HTML and stuff. So you can pause this video and type that out if you like. But this is the email body that I usually use, and you can see you're passing the HTML and the subject to it, and it simply adds the subject to the email in the necessary places, as well as the body in the necessary place right there, so that it gets sent in a way that it's more appropriate. And then that's all happening right here, okay, and that is what I'm passing in here. So a custom method which gets the data from the Ajax and then sends it off. So that's a quick tutorial on how to implement sending emails through your component using the email helper class. Obviously the email helper class is available on GitHub in the component builder. And if you feel that our implementation lacks some professional help, then please do make a commit request or send me an email, and we'll gladly update and improve this class. Although I think we have followed all the necessary standards and requirements to make it useful to everyone. Okay, thanks for watching. Until next time. Take care.